Hold your nose, because we're letting rip the worst smells in the natural world. It's a dirty job, but someone's gotta count down the top 10 most extreme stinkers in the animal kingdom and compare them to our own smelly instincts. Discover who's ahead by a nose when stink is taken to the most extreme. Earth is a planet of extremes. Extreme places and extreme animals. But some animals are more extreme than others. Join us as we count down to find the most unusual, the most extraordinary, the most extreme. Walking in to number 10 in the countdown is an animal that can kick up a real stink. They may be our best friends, but even the most devoted dog lover has to admit that Rover can smell revolting. They have a nasty habit of rolling in anything that stinks, and they just love sticking their noses into the nastiest places. No wonder we take their hygiene seriously. When it comes to smelly behavior, dogs have no hang-ups, and it's all thanks to their ancestor, the wolf. A wolf will roll in any stinky substance because it's a great way to mask its own scent so it can sneak up on dinner. Today, the wolf's descendants still love to roll in anything that smells bad. And this gets right up our nose. Literally. That's because when we encounter something that smells bad, molecules have evaporated off the noxious substance and floated through the air up into your nose. At the top of your nasal passages is a patch of special neurons about the size of a postage stamp. They're covered in hair-like projections that catch the odor molecules and then trigger the nerves that tell your brain there's a smell in the air. Our ability to sniff out stinks is very important. According to researcher at the Monell Chemical Senses Center in Philadelphia, Pam Dalton.
Bad smells have significant potential to give us information about things that we should avoid. And they do so very quickly. Sometimes we react to the presence of a bad odor even before our brains have consciously processed why we want to move out of this environment. Something that smells like rotting food or human waste, which we've probably been taught from the time we were little children. Don't touch that. If your mother takes you into a public toilet, the first thing they say is, you know, don't touch anything in here. So we readily acquire the belief and the understanding that this is something that might hurt us.
But imagine if we could smell as well as dogs. Their sense of smell is a million times more sensitive than ours. That's because their long snouts have more than 10 times the area of smell receptor cells, and their wet noses act like Velcro, trapping scent molecules as they drift by. Dogs live in a world dominated by smell. That's why they're fascinated with each other's rear ends. They're the canine equivalent of business cards. Thanks to anal glands that emit a small amount of their contents with every wag of the tail. And you thought they were just pleased to see you. Dogs often prefer to take a more direct route with their messages. Both urine and droppings contain important scent signals that pass on information about the dog's sex, health, and even its mood. So the next time your pet dog leaves a message on your carpet, remember, it might just be trying to tell you how much it loves you. Every year, thousands of visitors travel to Florida, attracted by the sea, sun, and scenery. But not all the tourists that flock here are welcome. Meet the vulture. It's firmly perched at number 9 in the countdown because it has a truly disgusting way of keeping cool in the Florida sun. Unlike humans, vultures have no sweat glands. So, to cool themselves down, when the going gets hot, the hot get going. They go on their feet. The mixture of urine and feces becomes a smelly cooling fluid and is actually more energy efficient than sweating. We may be disgusted at the vulture's foul behavior, but don't forget that our sweat glands can also produce some awful odors.
Maybe that's why even your best friends won't tell you.
Are you trying to tell me that I smell?
Oh, no, Homer. I smell. You stink.
Thankfully, when we exercise, we don't have to excrete on our feet to cool down. Instead, there are more than 2 million sweat glands in our skin that secrete mostly water that cool. But under our armpits, it's a different story. The sweat produced by these glands contains proteins and fatty acids. And that's the perfect food for bacteria. And when the bacteria under our armpits excrete their waste products, we start to stink. That's why we only apply antiperspirants and deodorants to our armpits. And probably why 72% of American women surveyed said it was the one personal care product they couldn't live without. Of course, vultures have no need for antiperspirants. For a start, they don't perspire. But also, it seems the bacteria don't stand a chance against the vulture's novel approach to personal hygiene. Scientists have discovered that the high concentration of ammonia in vulture urine kills bacteria. And the best part is that when you lunch at the local landfill, no one will notice that your feet smell like a sewer. We've sniffed out the first two contenders. But coming up, just what is the worst smell in the world? And why do some animals start fuming when you get in their face? Find out next on The Most Extreme. Travel down a river in Africa, and you stand a good chance of getting a noseful of number 8 in our countdown of extreme stinkers. But it could be the last thing you ever smell. The hippopotamus is famous for its ability to detach your head from your shoulders with a single bite. But hippos have another way of overwhelming opposition, and it's truly disgusting. The hippo's secret weapon is the result of its diet. Every night, a hippo puts away over 100 kilograms of vegetation. As it travels through the hippo's massive intestines, it starts fermenting, breaking down into a smelly soup. By the end of its journey, the plant material has become a stinky green grenade, ready to be thrown at any rival that gets too close for comfort. Hippos are number 8 in the countdown, thanks to the dominance display known as dung showering. Males show who's boss by twirling their tails like propellers to ensure the dung really hits the fan. Luckily, most human males don't try to distribute their toilet smells, although in the past, things were different. In the Middle Ages, loudly breaking wind was an act of appreciation to the housewife. And we certainly have a lot of wind to break. Each day, the average human toots the trouser trumpet about 10 times and produces about 1.5 liters of digestive gases. Imagine if you could collect the gases produced by all the people in the world in one day. You'd have enough gas to fill 13 blimps. And if you analyze the composition of our digestive gases, you'd find that the main ingredients are all odorless. The smell comes from the tiniest traces of sulfur. Onions and garlic are full of sulfur. Other foods like beans and cabbage are broken down by bacteria that produce sulfurous stenches. And that's why when it comes to passing gas, you are what you eat. Unfortunately, some animals have been eating things that have been creating an environmental mess. Flatulent cows have long been blamed for producing the greenhouse gases suspected of causing global warming. It's estimated that the 100 million cattle in the United States expel about 6 million tons of methane into the atmosphere every year. But it turns out that cows may have had a bum rap. Contrary to popular belief, not a lot of the digestive gases are released out the rear end. It seems that cows burp a lot. But when it comes to pollution, the hippo is at the top of the heap. Every year, a hippo deposits 9 tons of pre-digested food back in the river, which always draws a crowd of happy hippo hanger-oners. So far, we've seen dung being flung, birds on the run, and dogs having fun. But coming up, we'll huff and we'll puff with bad breath that'll really blow you away. That's next on The Most Extreme. To find the next contender in our countdown of extreme stinkers, we're traveling to the southern coast of New Zealand and going in search of hookers. You'll smell them before you see them, because these hookers are huge, fat, and hairy. Say hello to the hooker's sea lion. It's number 7 in the countdown because it has extreme halitosis. They may be the rarest sea lions in the world, but if you get too close to a colony of hookers, you'll quickly learn that they have spectacularly stinky breath. Their bad breath is nearly as deadly as their teeth, and it's all because of their diet. These hookers like fish, lots of fish. A sea lion will eat 30 kilograms of fish every day on its underwater hunting trips. It's an incredible swimmer that can dive down more than 400 meters and hold its breath for an astonishing 12 minutes. Perhaps this is the best time to meet a hooker, when it's holding its breath. A sea lion can live for more than 20 years on its fishy diet. That's an awful long time without brushing or flossing. And that's why this hooker has such a foul mouth. Pieces of rotting food trapped in the teeth create bad breath for both hookers and humans. That's why so many people make such a song and dance about brushing your teeth.
Brush them up and brush them down. Keep your choppers clean and sound. Help your teeth to stay around until you're old and gray.
If you want breath like a hooker sea lion, simply stop brushing your teeth. Scraps of food will start decomposing in your mouth. Bacteria will flourish and start releasing the sulfurous gases that are the prime cause of bad breath. An estimated 60 million Americans suffer from chronic halitosis, but not one of them can compare to the hooker sea lion. As if rotting fish breath wasn't bad enough, these extreme stinkers have found another way to add a foul flavor. Throwing up is the perfect way to get rid of those indigestible fishy leftovers and to add the aroma of vomit to an already putrid breath. When we're in the wilderness, it's easy to get lost. But our next contender never has to ask directions because it's surrounded by stinky signposts. The plains of Africa are home to number 6 in the countdown, the spotted hyena. The savanna may look deserted to us, but the average hyena is hardly ever more than 50 meters from a foul-smelling scent marker produced by a hyena's backside. These stinky scavengers live in a world dominated by smell. Packs of hyenas mark their territory by covering the landscape in a foul-smelling paste. They make about 145,000 of these smelly signposts each year. At night, hyenas really get down to business. Smelly business. Hyenas are number 6 in the countdown because they turn their anal pouches inside out to produce the stinky paste known as hyena butter. Eat Each pasting is so potent that it'll continue to reek for an amazing 30 days, broadcasting information about the pack to any hyena that strays into their territory. But hyenas aren't the only creatures who use smell to communicate. In 1960, Hollywood saw the premiere of The Scent of Mystery, which was filmed in glorious smell-o-vision. The theater had been specifically modified to pump smells over the audience. The idea was that people would experience the smells of, say, a barbecue at the same time as the action was sizzling on screen. Unfortunately, smell-o-vision was plagued with problems. Audiences received the smells out of sync, and between showings, it was difficult to flush the scents out of the theaters. As word of nose spread, the idea was abandoned. Unlike human audiences, hyenas would have loved smell-o-vision. Although all that hyena butter probably wouldn't taste so good on the popcorn. When hyenas get down and dirty, it can be a real crowd pleaser. But coming up next, could this shaggy beast hold a stinky secret to bring out the animal in you? That's next on The Most Extreme. We've been using perfumes for thousands of years. Today, there's a $20 billion industry based on the fact that we don't like our own stink. But have you ever wondered what goes into the perfumes you wear? Before the development of a synthetic replacement, most perfumes contained a foul-smelling extract from a musk deer's anal glands. Perfumers used extreme dilutions of the deer's rear because in its natural state, real musk really stinks. So you'd think that the biggest producer of musk in the world would be the animal that's coming in at number 5 in the countdown. The musk ox. Surprisingly, the so-called musk ox doesn't make musk, and it's not an ox. This shaggy creature is more closely related to a sheep than an ox, and it doesn't have musk glands. Musk ox musk is actually urine. Try putting that in your perfume. Male musk ox liberally douse themselves with pee to see who can make the biggest stink. Stand downwind, and the musky smell is strong enough to make your eyes water. And if the smell alone isn't enough to scare off the competition, they use their heads. Maybe you need to be knocked about the head to think that musk is a sexy fragrance. But if musk smells so bad, why has it been used in perfumes? For centuries, tiny amounts of musk were used as a fixative to amplify the other fragrances in the perfume. The dawn of disco ushered in a new era for purified musk oil. Some thought the earthy animal odor was linked to the sexuality of testosterone. That's why dance floors in the 70s were saturated with the sweet smell of animal anal glands. However, not even the most ardent disco king would consider wearing a perfume of musk ox urine. Lacking the fixative chemicals found in real musk oil, this is one extreme stink that will only ever make an impact with other headbangers. Our next contender is the biggest stinker on the planet. The bull elephant is number 4 in the countdown because for 1 month every year, it really stinks. Take a close look at a bull's head and you can see a small gland between the eye and the ear. When the bull's testosterone levels skyrocket, this gland dribbles out a rancid-smelling secretion called must. In Hindi, must means intoxicated, because bull elephants in must are the pachyderm equivalent of college students at spring break. They're sex-crazed, aggressive, and smell really, really bad. Female elephants, on the other hand, find the awful odor a real turn-on. They interpret the pungent smell as a sign of a healthy, virile bull. But other males are less impressed with the odor. Elephants in must have been known to kill each other in the fight for the right to mate. However, for males in their early teens, must is a much sweeter experience. Teenage elephants smell of honey and flowers. This sweet aroma keeps young males out of trouble because you need to smell bad to enter the world of sex and violence. Even humans that smell bad can get some good loving. All humans secrete pheromones as a part of their natural body odor. These chemicals send subtle messages that affect our behavior. It seems the less we wash, the more pheromones we release. Perhaps that's why breathing deep can really inflame desire. Dr. Winifred Cutler of the Athena Institute in Pennsylvania is an expert when it comes to invisible attractants.
By 1993, I had created a formula that we could actually give to people to put in their perfume. And when they did that, things happened.
As part of an independent study, researchers laced women's favorite perfume with either Dr. Cutler's synthetic pheromone or a placebo. At the end of the study, the group wearing the synthetic pheromone reported an amazing increase in affectionate encounters of more than 70%. Dr. Cutler has used her research to commercially develop chemical extracts of human sex pheromones for both women and men. And according to many, the results are nothing to sniff at. Unfortunately, elephant perfume has been described as smelling like 1,000 goats in a pen. No wonder adolescent male elephants are kicked out of the herd as soon as they start to stink. So far, we've seen jumbos that reek, oxen that leak, and a hyena's mean streak. But it'll be a real gas when we meet a bug that fights using stench warfare. That's next on the most extreme. The next contender in our countdown of extreme stinkers can be found in forests around the world. Most people think of millipedes as harmless vegetarians. But if they get threatened, they can create such a stink that even the hungriest hunter would turn up its nose at them. Someone who knows firsthand just how malodorous millipedes can be is Brent Karner, insect zoo coordinator at the Los Angeles Natural History Museum.
This creature I'm bringing out here is a large tropical millipede from eastern Africa. Many millipedes are very unique in that they have the ability to spray noxious compounds at would-be predators. These compounds tend to stop the predator from attacking the millipede or looking at it as food. The spray usually is very or makes the millipede appear very unappetizing. The smell is usually a very musky smell. If I bring it close enough to my nose, I can smell a bit of a foul, musky odor. I wouldn't hold all millipedes that close to my nose, though, to get that smell. There are some species that can actually forcibly spray a noxious chemical.
The millipede's self-defense system would make any chemical engineer proud. When it's in danger, the millipede mixes two chemicals together in reaction chambers along the side of its body. Enzymes then convert the harmless liquid into clouds of the deadly gas, hydrogen cyanide. One millipede is capable of storing enough reactants to form 0.2 milligrams of hydrogen cyanide, enough to kill animals as large as mice. That means 300 millipedes could create enough deadly gas to kill a human. Millipedes are number three in the countdown because no other animal makes such a lethal stink. But hydrogen cyanide is expensive to make, so by preference, a millipede would rather run than reek. It certainly has formidable foot power to make a speedy getaway. With hundreds of limbs, it's a good thing millipedes don't suffer from smelly feet, unlike some humans. According to a recent survey, one in five Americans admits to sometimes having smelly feet. Your feet smell because of bacteria that feed on sweat. Each hard-working foot is covered in 250,000 sweat glands, which can produce about 0.5 liters of sweat each day. That means in your lifetime, your feet will pump out enough sweat to fill a swimming pool. That's about 25,000 liters of sweat. But not everyone has a problem with stinky feet. Every year in Montpelier, Vermont, foul feet are celebrated in the annual International Rotten Sneaker Contest. Dozens of kids and their sweat-soaked sneakers compete for the top prize. Every year, the winning sneakers are enshrined in the Hall of Fumes, a hermetically sealed trophy case where they can decompose with honor. The millipede doesn't need to take off its sneakers to make a stink, because when it comes to olfactory assaults, these guys can sock it to you naturally. But if stinky millipedes make you sick, you just won't believe what's hurled at you by our next contender. There's something very rotten in the Southern Ocean. But our next contender thinks that decay smells delicious. Diving in to number two in the countdown is the giant petrel. This huge bird has such revolting personal habits that sailors call it the stinker. Stinkers are the vultures of the southern seas. They'll eat anything rotten. But this putrid diet is only one reason why a stinker stinks. This smelly scavenger is number two in the countdown because it has a secret weapon. Climb too close to nesting petrels, and you can get a very nasty surprise. Stinkers hurl chunks. The petrel's projectile vomit smells really disgusting and is so acidic that it eats through the waterproof coating on feathers, no matter how hard you try to wash it off. But stinkers aren't the only ones who use foul smells as weapons. In World War II, the French resistance were looking for a way to harass the invading Germans. So their American allies developed a highly secret, highly stinky weapon. It was a chemical to put into stink bombs designed to be thrown at German officers. The plan was to make the officers smell as though they'd soiled themselves. Hence the name, who, me? Unfortunately, things didn't quite go to plan. The mixture was so unstable that it would often leave whole towns soaked in the stench. Perhaps the French resistance may have been better off using the projectile weapons of the stinker. Or even arming themselves with the animal that's number one in the countdown. We've smelled the nine contenders. They're the worst of the worst. Only one animal is a more extreme stink-making machine. It's number one, and it's coming up next on The Most Extreme. We've tracked the most extreme stinker in the countdown to this home in Orlando, Florida.
Wilson, sleepyhead. Hi, big boy. Come on. Come on. It's time to eat.
It's the skunk.
Come on, it's time to eat. That's my big boy.
Jamie Kinster shares her home with not one, but 11 of the world's most extreme stinkers.
Everybody wants food. Come on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of you. That means I'm missing 5.
So why would anyone want to live with so many skunks?
They're cuddly, they're quiet, they're clean. They're very social animals. I started out with one, and it's sort of like having
potato chips. You can't just have just one.
There may be up to 5 million pet skunks in America today. Professional breeders meet the demand by supplying skunks whose scent glands have been surgically removed. So while there are no stink bombs in the Kintzer house, even Jamie admits that wild skunks can be real stinkers.
It's probably one of the worst smells. It could bring tears to your eyes. It does temporarily blind you. It's kind of hard to explain what exactly it smells like. One of the worst things you can possibly smell, other than maybe something dead.
So what is the worst smell in the world? A nationwide survey of Americans tried to find out. Offensive bathroom odors were ranked in fourth place by 38% of respondents. Then came the smell of dirty diapers. Rotten eggs got 47% of the vote. But the clear winner, according to 60% of all people polled, was the skunk. The skunk is number one in the countdown, thanks to two walnut-sized scent glands in its rear end. Even baby skunks are armed and dangerous. If you're sprayed, people over 2 kilometers downwind will be able to smell you. And the skunk sulfurous cocktail actually sticks to you because one chemical in the spray attaches to the proteins in hair and wool. Another ingredient reacts with the water in your sweat, so you keep stinking for days. So why do skunks have such smelly superpowers? Most predators learn the hard way. The skunk's two scent glands are powerful guns, capable of squirting over 4 meters. If it misses with the first shot, it can fire again up to 6 times before it runs out of its stinky ammunition. No wonder scientists are taking a closer look at the skunk's smelly six-shooter. At the Monell Chemical Senses Center in Philadelphia, a team of researchers are really getting up people's noses in their search for the mother of all stink bombs. To sniff out the most universally despised odors in the world, brave volunteers are exposed to a range of disgusting smells. Their reactions are scientifically monitored from the safety of another chamber. And that's when things really start to get stinky.
Okay.
Oh. 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 How bad was it? It was absolutely foul. As far as what it smelled like, it's hard to describe. It's like trash left out in the sun for a few days, combined with like a bathroom odor. It's like, I don't know, took like a dead cat and put it in a bag and left it in the sun for like a week. Oof.
It's actually a concoction called stench soup, the worst smell in the world, according to malodor researcher Pam Dalton.
Stench soup was actually sort of an accident. We needed to dispose of many of our chemicals, and what we found was that when we were mixing two of our worst malodors, the human waste odor and the rotting flesh odor, that the disposal bottle actually smelled a lot worse than either of the two of them independently. Stench seems to be a pretty good way to describe it. It doesn't really smell on first breath, like either the fecal matter or the rotting flesh, but both of those components come through as you start to experience it.
It's hoped that stench soup may one day provide the ultimate in non-lethal crowd control. Imagine dropping a stink bomb that will disperse rioters in empty streets. But a skunk knows how to clear the streets instinctively. That's why if you're gonna trash the skunk's reputation, it pays to stand well clear. Because when it comes to stinks, there can be no doubt that the skunk really is the most extreme.